Welcome to Hot Copy. Catholics around the country now observe the Holy Week with prayer, fasting, and penance. But the Catholic Church opposes forms of penance that involve serious physical pain. Caroline Howard tells us more.
The Lenten season, especially Holy Week for Catholics, is a time to reflect on the Paschal mystery, the passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. In Baliwag, Bulacan, the images of saints are paraded in the streets every Holy Week, a tradition that peaks on Good Friday.
Yung kasiyahan ng kalooban ko, namayayos ko yan, yun ang lang aking nakukuha sa pamilya ko na walang nang masyado nagkakasakit sa amin.
In Bani, Pangasinan, devotees flock to the Redeemer's Cross for the Surip pilgrimage. They take 1,000 steps for the Stations of the Cross. In Misamis Occidental, pilgrims also troop to the Fort Santiago in Ozamis City to offer flowers and prayers to the miraculous Virgin of Cota.
Gaya ng may mga kapansanan, nagsasabi, sige lang anak, kapag mubuti na ang kalagayan mo, bukas, magsindi tayo ng kandila. Hindi sila makapaniwala, kinabukasan, nakakalakad na.
But as a faithful turn to religious traditions, the Church frowns on the practice of self-flagellation when penitents flog themselves as a form of physical sacrifice or personal penance. Some even have themselves nailed on the cross to reenact Jesus Christ's own crucifixion. The Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines says such practices show a wrong understanding of the Church teaching. It adds inflicting pain on oneself is not an authentic expression of faith. Instead, the CBCP calls on the faithful to engage in prayer and fitting acts of penance and make amends with Mother Earth. Caroline Howard, ABS-CBN News.
And joining us on Hot Copy, Caloocan Bishop Deogracias Iniguez Jr., Chairman of the Public Affairs Committee of the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines. Good day to you, Bishop. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning.
Good morning,
and to all your viewers.
Well, thank you. Well, let's get straight to the meat of the issue. As we all know, of course, the whole country, all the Catholics all over the world are celebrating and reflecting this Holy Week. But we do have some of our kababayans, some of our brothers and sisters that do choose to do some, I guess, probably the better word to say is cultural activities to show their penance publicly and inflict harm. But officially, how does the Church look at this? And then how did this all start, really? I mean, was this something that was done way back and it was just passed on generations?
Well, we can say that Holy Week is actually the climax of the faith celebration of the Church, or what we call the liturgical year.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And so it's here that we remember, we try to understand more and enter into the spirit of the true event, of the reality, of the truth that we are actually celebrating, and that is the Paschal mystery, meaning the passion and death and the resurrection and glory of Jesus Christ. And it is there that we find what we believe, that we gain what we call redemption. And so for the Catholic Church and for Christians, this is actually the height of our celebration of faith. So this is a religious affair. And connected with this, of course, are the events that we celebrate and the realities and the truth that are contained in them. Now, with this come different understanding, depending on how these persons really have been instructed with regard to their faith. There are some who are solidly instructed in it. There are some who are just very, very shallow in their understanding and their exercise of faith. And therefore, they're engaged in some what we call these traditional practices, which many have inherited, but have actually failed to enter into the real spirit of these practices.
Okay. And when you say instructed, Bishop, who, what instructs them to do what they choose to do?
Well, faith is in its very big part understanding of the truths and the realities, and this is what is supposed to be carried on in the family. So this being born in the faith and this growing in faith that is rooted in the family. Mm-hmm. And of course, the church as an institution has that special concern mm-hmm. to see to it that the Christians, the Catholics, are properly instructed, that they are properly rooted, no, mm-hmm. in the truths of the faith.
Well, as you said, Bishop, that it is, you know, the mystery of the passion, death of Christ, and to some, it is a mystery why they do this. You know, to we try to understand what it means to them to inflict pain on themselves. Do they really want to physically emulate what Christ went through as much as possible? Of course, stopping to the point of dying literally on the cross. Mm-hmm. No, but have you ever encountered anybody who has done this and asked them really why they choose to go this far in terms of showing a sacrifice or doing some sort of physical penance?
Well, I have come to talk with some Catholics mm-hmm. who have their, we call panata. Mm-hmm. No? They have their promise right. that when this time comes, they would undergo some acts right. no? in order to join the spirit of the celebration. Mm-hmm. And there are many things that they promise to do. Mm-hmm. And some of them are these self-inflicted sacrifices, which from their understanding of tradition in the church mm-hmm. and in some practices that they have really been born into mm-hmm. and also in some we may say deficient explanation mm-hmm. of these practices, they have really engaged and they continue to carry out these practices.
And for some of them, it's hard to stop them from doing so because some of them, as you said, it has been their commitment and their penance to do so. Because some of them as well, gumaling po sa mga sakit, you know, a miracle had happened in their family and this is their way of thanks that they would say, okay, every year, every Holy Week, magpapaganito po ako to remind me of what I went through and kayo po, Lord, ang umahon sa akin at binigyan niyo ako ng milagro. Yung mga ganong tao po, how can you still convince them that you don't have to do this, you don't have to inflict this physical harm on yourself to show your love and thanks to the Lord? I mean, and as you said, sometimes it's a matter of the way it's explained mm-hmm. by the local priest, I guess, yes. the local parish priest.
By the catechists, yes, by as the well. Parents. Mm-hmm. No?
And how would you explain it to them that it's not necessary, but for them, kahit hindi siguro nakasulat sa Bible, in their heart, it says, this is how we'll thank
that's
the
right,
Lord.
That's right.
No? But how would you approach that situation?
Well, it's a matter of trying to bring to them mm-hmm. no, the totality of the realities and the truths of our faith. Mm-hmm. And that's really not something that you can give instantaneously or something that you can give up for some time. Mm-hmm. We can say that it's actually something that one has to grow into. Mm-hmm. So the reality of faith is not limited, no? Actually, it's a very, very deep, and it's a very, very all-embracing reality. And so it's just, as the church instructs us, it has to be an ongoing formation mm-hmm. on the realities of our faith.
And when these things happen, Bishop, who helps them put this whole production together? Because it's a major production. I mean, we see, you know, a long line of people walking with crosses, and then some of them end up at the very end of it, literally getting themselves nailed onto mm-hmm. the cross. But, I mean, I can imagine there are some places that just do it for the show, to do it for to physically see, you know, people walk with their crosses, and nagpapatali lang. Okay lang siguro yung tali, no? Would you be alright with yung nagpapatali lang? And not to the point that may paku na talaga and they're flagelling themselves and making them bleed. But who puts this whole thing together? Is it the local churches as well, or is it the local communities, like their barangay or?
No, well, I think historically mm. we can say that it is something that started some time mm-hmm. and then it was passed on
okay.
to the children and to the next generation. Mm-hmm. And in these particular places, it has become something that is usual. Yeah. And so people come to witness mm-hmm. it, especially those who come out of, we may say, religious curiosity. Mm-hmm. And even it comes to the point that there are really promoters of it, like, for instance, the barrio or a certain group in that locality in order to invite people to the particular place.
All right, okay. So in a sense, it becomes some sort of a novelty for the area, for the town, for the barangay. To attract attention as well.
It becomes something peculiar that really attracts attention.
Okay. Would you say that that may potentially take away from the solemnity and the sincerity of the event, of what they're supposed to observe during this Holy Week?
What we can say is that if these people who go there, they are also not that deeply instructed in their faith, this may influence them negatively.
Okay. Well, clearly, we can gather that these people who do this, who choose to do this to themselves, are doing this as an extreme way of showing their thanks, their faith, or some sort of sacrifice, praying for something, possibly praying for a miracle in the family or what. What would be the best alternative, or I guess the proper practice at this time of the year? Would you, how would you advise them that you don't need to do this, but you just have to do this in terms of showing the Lord your faith, showing the Lord how badly you need something in your life, or in thanks to Him as well?
Well, during these days, which we call the Holy Week, and also during the whole liturgical year, the best way for us Catholics, Christians, is actually to participate in the religious celebrations of the church, in the official celebrations, what we call the liturgy. That would be the best way, really, of celebrating, of entering into the real spirit of what we are celebrating. So that's what we encourage our faithful, that they try to see what are the scheduled religious activities in the church, and they try to participate in it actively and with full understanding.
Right. Well, we'll be talking more about that and other practices as well. We'll be taking a quick break, and when we return, our guest, Bishop Deogracias Iniguez, will answer questions from you, our viewers, as you tweet them and send them to us on Facebook. Hot Copy. We'll be right back.